morning, good evening, Sarah, wherever you are in the world. Thank you for joining us on this episode of the Digital Access Show. This is where we talk about communication, accessibility, and usability, because after all, accessibility plus good usability, good accessibility, is going to only give good communication. In the last couple of weeks, we've been looking at the theme of communication itself, and this is where I wanted to talk to Laura. Laura, I met a couple of times at different meetings. I've heard her present. She is awesome. Laura is all about empowerment. Everyone, please meet Laura McIntosh from Stepping Into Your Power. Laura, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate being invited to your amazing podcast.
Oh, thank you. Laura, can you tell us a bit about yourself? How you started, why you're doing what you're doing.
So how I started was I realized that I wanted to improve myself. So I realized that what I was doing was not my purpose. And it just didn't suit me. So I did further studies and now I'm a mindset coach. So I have my accreditations in neuro-linguistic programming and also hypnotherapy. Neuro-linguistic programming is the neuro being the brain, linguistic being the language, and programming is all those memories we pull on to actually have a reaction to something. So, yes. And then I now do my purpose every day. And why I do what I do is because I love making changes in people's lives, whether it be a small change or a big change. I just love their look that they get. And I know that when they go out into the world, that they're going to make changes with other people as well. So, that's what I do,
You actually have a great message. As I said, I've seen one of your, I think I've seen a couple of your presentations now, and you just make so much sense. Laura, the reason why I wanted you on here today is, as I said, we've been talking about communication in the last couple of episodes and really focusing in the last episode on what are the barriers that are still there and why are they still there. And Andrew Backhouse from Queenslanders with Disability Network made a really good point. He said, other than the fact that people are just not aware that the barriers are there, it's people with disability themselves accept that the barriers are there. They accept they can't read the document or they can't hear something or they can't physically do something. Now, in this day of technology, digital technology, that's not the case anymore. The ways and the means are there, but it's that acceptance level that is creating a barrier as well. What can be done about it?
Look, it's the way people look at the way the world is. And a great example of that is I have a gorgeous daughter, an older daughter, who is intellectually impaired. So we got her NDIS plan, and I could have looked at that and gone, oh, that looks like a great deal of money. But then I started working it out, and I could have accepted that and gone, yeah, this is what we've got. We now need to make sure how is our daughter going to go into the world using the NDIS money? And then I realized, you know what? I could just sit there and accept it, or I could actually take action and get more money for her because I realized that what we want to do and what my daughter actually really wants to do, Lordy, what she wants to do is be in the world. And the money that they gave us was not enough. So as a mum, I took action and I went forward and did a lot of research, got all the information they required, all the reports, and we all know that's a lot of reports, and sent that through to them, and then just kept bugging them because I was not going to let my Lordy be a victim, get the NDIS, and then play Warris me that we don't have enough money. And that's what gets me into. We've probably all heard of playing above the line and playing below the line. So, am I sitting above the line or am I sitting below the line? So, what does that mean? It actually means cause and effect. So, am I at effect? And when I'm at effect, I'm actually blaming everything else. So, let's have a look at that. X means Y. So, I got Laura's NDIS plan. I looked at it and went, it's not enough money. I could have said it's too hard. Like we've obviously been in a review, it's too hard to go again. And it's just NDIS makes it too complicated. So X means Y. And what I'm doing is I'm playing the victim to the action that would actually came. So I, rather than being that, I then went above the line and played at a cause. So playing at cause, you are actually taking responsibility for what has come through, rather than saying, well, it's just too hard, or somebody else will do it for me. So it's taking that, so making you powerless. So if you are in the situation where something comes through and you feel powerless, you start blaming other people, other environments, other doctors, you know, he wasn't that good or she wasn't that good, then you're playing below the line. You're playing at effect. So when you think of effect, think of yourself always being back in bed. So, and back in bed means you're blaming. So am I blaming? Am I doing X means Y? So this means this and I can't move. Am I making excuses up? And like, oh, you know what? I just don't have time. I don't have time. Unless you've got a time machine, that's not going to change. You're always going to be in the present moment in that time. And then D means denial. So think, am I being holding myself back? So when you something happens and you feel like you cannot move, so stand up or sit down or wherever, but am I moving forward or am I staying back? Am I staying in bed? So am I blaming? Am I making excuses or am I doing denial? Or am I going to go above the line and actually take ownership? So this is Lordy's plan. I'm owning that. You know, I'm going to own this plan and I'm going to be becoming accountable for the money that has come through. And you know what? I'm going to be responsible for my daughter, for myself, to actually take action. So think of yourself now, you've got your oar and you're actually rowing forward in life. Am I actually rowing forward in life or would I rather be back in bed? And if you want to row forward in life, then you take ownership, you take accountability. And you take responsibility for yourself as well. Because you know what? You are the only person that can make the change. And if you're looking around for someone else to make that change, guess what? You're back in bed. So you might as well pull the covers over your head because I'm going to give you an oar and I'm going to get you out of that bed. And you need to take from today, and I know you will take ownership. You'll absolutely take ownership of everything that comes in, taking ownership. And you start to ask yourself the questions. How can I do this? How am I responsible for this? And by doing this, what will that give me? And that's the biggest question. What will this give me? Because if I'm in bed, what will this give me? Well, I've got no power. So let's take our power back. And let's get the oar and take ownership, accountability, and responsibility. And always ask yourself the question, what is this in, what is this, what is it in for me? So why am I doing this? What's it in for me? And if you can answer that, and I know you will, without saying, oh, I need to do this, I need to do that, I need to do the other, because we're making excuses, then we are way above the line. Absolutely above the line. And a great man, Robert Dilts, actually says, to be at cause is to recognize your role in shaping your reality. To be at effect is to surrender your power to someone else. Let's read, I'll read that again to you. To be at cause is to recognize your role in shaping your reality. To be at effect is to surrender your power to someone else. And I know no one wants to do that. So I
And
know
just
you're going to grab that oar and use that oar to get you out of bed.
you're so right. I've brought my kids up to say, and I kept telling them, people are only going to change when there is enough of a reason for them to want to change themselves. No one else is
Yeah.
going to change them. And I'm hoping my boys have really got that and understand that. The interesting thing, I love the BED and the OR acronyms. They are great things because they're so simple. But what is that first step someone can take? If they're in the bed, what's the very first step? Is it lying there and thinking, hang on, I do have to take ownership? Or is it something even smaller than that? What's the first step that someone can do?
First step someone can do is actually close their eyes and think to themselves or say to themselves, I love you. I love you. And you is you. I love you. And keep saying it until you take that first step. I love you. I love you. And it's about yourself. I love you. And when we say, I love you, and we feel it from the top of our head to the tips of our toes, we'll take our first step.
It's also trusting yourself enough too, isn't it? That you trust that.
Trust means different things to different people.
Well, to me, I would say trust is trusting that, okay, I'm going to be brave enough, even though it's scary. Taking that first step is scary, but I can do it.
And you can also ask yourself, how am I contributing to myself? How am I making a contribution to myself? How am I contributing to this? What can I do differently? And I think we all, from my perspective, people can get stuck in there. Oh, I did this. And it, you did do that. And well done for doing that. Now, thinking about that, if you knew how to do it differently, what would you do?
And that's it, isn't it? Every step in life, every hour that we live, there's a chance to learn.
Yeah.
And I think getting out of that bed and taking that all also gives us a chance to learn.
It does. It does. And it, look, learning is a beautiful thing. I learn every day, absolutely every day. And I'm curious. Like, I am so curious about how things work, how things happen, why I do what I do. And it makes me curious. And when people, so whether you're having to sit down, whether you're even having to lie down, in your mind, just say to yourself, am I moving forward? Is my mind powering forward? Am I stepping into my power? And it may just be a little word. So we use the word, and we talked about how we can get out of bed.
Yes.
I have to do this. I must do this. And I know everybody will from today. I get to do this. I get to make the change. I get to get myself out of bed. So that one little word, and what I'm saying is, think of the word that you're actually using. It feels like it's holding you here, or does it feel like it's pushing you forward? And can sometimes people be pushing back? Get, I get, I get to get up in the morning. I get to hear what's going around. I get to feel what's moving. So that one little word can make all the difference.
And it is, it's words. And as you said, it's your mindset with, blaming others, excuses, and BED, and I can't remember what the D was for me.
Denial.
Denial. And that's it. And that's a mindset. Whereas ownership, accountability, relationships, moving forward. That's a positive thing. So, what are two takeaways that we could leave everyone with today?
Yeah, oh, look, have a think about draw yourself, whether it be in your mind. A line. So just draw the line. Am I below? Am I above? So when you are thinking about something or you're about to do something, just have a think. Is that holding me back? Am I below? Or am I above and way above? If you're below, just rephrase some terminologies. Rephrase. And have a think that what else can I do? What by me doing this, it will cause for me to have this effect. And just in your mind, am I stepping above or am I staying below? And listen to how people talk around you. Are they above or are they below? And by doing that, that helps you get above that line and regain your power. And then, when you've got that power, feel that power from the top of your head to the tips of your toes and just sit in it. And that's probably the other thing. When we are in our beautiful ownership and we are there with each other, with ourselves, take time out and feel that power, feel that joy, feel that happiness. And you know what? That's all yours. So stay in it and feel it. And then when you've had enough of it, then just step out and it's always going to be there.
Laura, I can't thank you enough. The message that you give and just the learnings you've just given in 15, 20 minutes, just incredible. So thank you. Laura, how can people contact you?
Yeah, look, I am on Facebook. I'm on LinkedIn, so Laura McIntosh, Facebook, Stepping Into Your Power. And I have my beautiful website, steppingintoyourpower.com.au. And I am here. Just think, I'm your curly redhead who packs an earbud. with her words and her messages. And remember, think of your brightest aura. Are you thinking? Is it everybody thinking of their brightest aura? Now add the L and you have Laura.
Fantastic. Look, thank you again, Laura. So yeah, Laura McIntosh, stepping into your power.com.au. We'll have the details at on a contact board at the end of the episode. So if you like what we do, please like, share, subscribe, review. We love feedback, good, bad, and ugly. Love it all. And we will see you next time. So thanks again, Laura, and have a great day, everyone, and step into your own power. See you.